Today we come to commemorate the event which won for us our salvation. The stations of the cross we call the suffering and death of Jesus, who took upon himself our sins so that he could open the gates of heaven for us. It is part of the Triduum, the three holiest days of the church year. On Holy Thursday, we remember the Last Supper when the Eucharist was instituted. The death and burial of Jesus is our focus on Good Friday, and the resurrection is celebrated at the Easter vigil on Holy Saturday evening. Because Jesus died for us and rose from the dead on Easter, we are free from our slavery to sin and able to hope for entrance into heaven. This is a celebration of our salvation. As we follow the path of Jesus on the way to Calvary, let us think about how these events apply to our lives. What do they mean for us today? How will they change our lives? Thank you in advance for your prayerful attention as we take part in this most sacred commemoration. We ask that at the end of the stations, you leave in silence as we enter the church today.
Lord, send out your blessing upon us as we come to recall the suffering and death of your Son. This death is our hope for resurrection. Grant us pardon for our sins and bring us comfort. Strengthen our faith and assure us of the eternal salvation which you have promised to those who love you and follow Jesus. Be with us on our journey. Amen.
Please stand. The first station. Jesus is condemned. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Please be seated. The soldiers brought Jesus to the Roman governor to be judged. The people wanted Jesus to be punished. They didn't know the governor knew his name and gave him to the ground. Jesus was condemned to death on the cross.
This is a hard story to tell. So many things happened. So many people were involved. There seemed to be so much hate in the air that day. It's hard to believe that this is a story about love. We were witnesses, though. We saw it all. The beating, the torture, the murder. It was awful. I can still hear the sounds of the crowd cheering, the soldiers shouting orders, and those crying women. It was a violent thing that happened. But yet, when I think about that day, a certain peace comes to me. Here's what happened. See if you know what I mean. I guess I showed up just about the time Jesus returned from Herod's court to Pilate's court. They sure played games with Jesus.
Any crime, but he accepted
Sometimes things do not go as you want them to go. You can't run away and take the easy way out. To really get anything out of life, you have to work at it every day. Jesus gave us his example. Even though it was hard and painful, he accepted all of our sins and took up the cross. Lord Jesus, give me strength to do the things I don't like to do.
Please stand. The third station. Jesus calls the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of your holy cross, you have redeemed me.
Oh!
Pass by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
This is what happened to Jesus, yet he did not complain.
beloved station, Jesus is crucified. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Laid it in a tomb, and on the rock, he rolled a large stone in front of it.
Jesus. Help us learn how to serve other people in our lives.
That was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was about to begin. The woman who had come from Galilee followed along behind. They saw the tomb and how the body was buried. Then they went back home to prepare the spices and perfumes. They observed the Sabbath as a day of rest, in keeping with Jewish law. All was quiet when I went home that day, but somehow I knew that the story wasn't going to end there.
Please exit.